Welcome to the Body Coach TV. My name's Joe Wicks and this is day number 7 of my 21 days of strength challenge. The focus today is going to be on back and biceps. So I'm going to be using 3 sets of dumbbells, a light set which is 6 kilograms, a medium set 16 kilograms and a heavier set 22 kilograms. But you can adapt and adjust the weights as you go. This is about you picking a weight. It's going to challenge you on the last sort of, you know, 3 or 4 reps of an exercise. You should be feeling a squeeze, you should be really contracting those muscles and it should be quite challenging. So the first exercise we're going to do using the light dumbbells, 2 sets, sort of like an activation exercise again, to really open up the back. We're going to basically retract the shoulder blades, so we're not coming close like this with the dumbbells. It's more 45 degree angle squeeze, as if you're trying to sort of bring your shoulder blades, retract your shoulder blades, squeeze your shoulders back together. So I'll show you with the weight. So this is why I've got quite a light weight. So you're not standing up straight, you're not bent over, you're not arching your back. You just want to keep a nice little soft bend in the knees. And from there, we're going to pull outwards. So imagine you're pulling those dumbbells out nice and wide, squeezing the muscle in your upper back and trying to focus on maximum contraction, bringing those dumbbells up nice and high. So again, it's not narrow, we're not coming on a fly. It's kind of a 45 degree angle. So just get that movement. We're going to squeeze that for 15 reps. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Squeeze the shoulders back together. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12, 13, 14, last rep. Ooh, and relax. So that, you will feel that a little bit in your lower back, but you just don't want to be like leaning right over. I'm really aiming sort of a slight angle there, just to allow myself to pull with the muscles in my upper back. So we're gonna do one more set of those. If that weight felt too light, maybe increase it. If it's too difficult, go a bit lighter. We're trying to get just those muscles in our upper back activated before we go into some of the heavier sets. So, have a little rest. Same again, second set. Every muscle in my body aches at the moment. My quads from that leg, from the leg workout, really on fire. It's those Bulgarian split lunges we did on the bench. They were tough. So every day is a different focus. We're working through the whole body and it's a 21 day challenge. This is day number 7. Okay, so picking those dumbbells up again. Right. So, side on, it's like this. Slight bend in the back. Straight back, slight lean over slightly forward. And then we pull them up and down. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Second set, 15 reps. 1. Maximum squeeze at the top. 2, 3, 4. Good. 5, doing 15 of these, 6, 7, really get those elbows up, 8, 9, 10, 11, pull them up, 12, 13, 14, last rep, and relax, right. Oh, awesome start. So we put those ones down. Give us a little rest. So next, spit it out. Next I want to do is single arm row. So this is where you're going to do a bench or a step. And what we're going to do is, I'm going to go with the heaviest ones I've got today for this. So heaviest ones I've got. And what I'm going to do is, single arm row. So from this side, let's go left knee on the bench, left hand on the bench. Form that nice sort of triangle base there. So right leg up to the side. Again, we're not arching the back, we're not trying to arch either way. Nice neutral spine, so nice flat back. And from there, what we're going to do is take the weight in the right hand and we're going to squeeze up towards the hips. Slowly lower it. And repeat. So we're not like, I'm not ripping it up and twisting my body around. I'm trying to keep everything nice and square onto the ground and just pulling with my, basically your biceps and your lats and your upper back. So don't just pull it directly up to the armpit. And that really focuses on the bicep. If you pull it towards your hip a little bit more, you'll activate all the muscles in your lats. Okay, so here we go. We're gonna go for 12 reps on the right side, then we switch. Okay, let's go. One, slowly down, control this weight. Two, three, four, good, nice control. Five, pull it to the hip. Six, seven, slow it down. Make the weight feel heavier. Eight, nine, 10, good last two reps. Think of the muscles you're working, squeeze, contract the muscles in your lats. Last one. That's perfect control, so slow. We're not just dropping it down and bouncing up, we're trying to control the move on the way up and the way down. So same again, left side, right knee on the bench again. Get that nice support, so we're taking that lower back out of the equation. We're just focusing on our upper back and our lats. 12 again, let's go. One. Two. Three. Four. That's it, controlled reps. Five. Six. Pull to the hip. Seven. Eight, nine, good weight this, 10, last two reps, 11, 12, and rest. Oh. Right, good set. Put that two more times, so time to adjust the weight. If it's too light, go a bit heavier. If it's too easy, it's going to be too hard. Drop it down, because it's much better to have a, you know, a lower weight with better form and control and getting that flight, you know, because you don't just get it to here. You need to squeeze it right up. Squeeze, lower. So that was one set, two more to go. If you can, think about 1 second or 1 or 2 seconds up, 2 seconds down. So just take that moment to really control the movement. Remember, more time and attention, more strength. Because I could lift heavier, but I'd be doing this. You see that? A lot in the gym. Go lighter, control it. Here we go, 12 reps. One. And we go down slow. Two. Three. Get that squeeze at the top. Maximum squeeze, four. And down. Five. And down, pull to the hips. Six, and down. Seven, eight, nine, 10, last two. Last rep. So remember, slow and controlled is the way forward. That felt harder. The second set, obviously, it's going to start to feel harder if you stick them the same weight because your muscles are fatiguing. But even if you can't do 12, even if you're aiming for 8 to 10, you might drop the reps a little bit. Try and stick with the weight. And so you keep the weight the same, but drop the reps a little bit if you need to. Okay, here we go. Second set. Left side. Remember, we're not pulling straight up like this. Pull to the hip for your lats. Engage, 12 reps, here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Nine is heavy now, come on. Last two. And rest. Ah. Brilliant. There's two down. One more set to go. Then we're gonna go into a couple of bicep curls, a couple of bicep sets. Then we're gonna finish on a back exercise. So, this is about strength training. So we're not doing mad fast reps or super high volume reps. We're trying to just keep it in there, sort of 10 to 12 reps, good little rep range. But the weight should be challenged. On the last 10, 11, 12 rep, you know, they should be like, you should be squeezing, it should be hard. If it's not, you're just not quite there with the weight. So just adjust them, get them right. Okay, last set. Here we go. Remember, your body will try and find the easiest way, which is gonna come straight up. Again, remember, think about the muscle trying to get all your upper back, your lats will pull, squeeze it back. 12 reps, right side. 3, 2, 1, let's lift. Right, 1, and down. 2, pull it to the hip. 3, 4, 5. Ah, it's a heavy, heavy set. 7. This is the set that gets us stronger. 8, 9, 10. Ah, 2 more. Final rep. Ah, that's me proper done on that last set. Right. Left side. Yeah, that is. That's me maxed out there. Right. Last side, remember, slow, controlled, exactly the same as the other side. You might find one side is a bit stronger than the other, but try not, one thing you're not doing is rip around, twist those hips, keep that, just take that equation, core engage, pull, and down. Okay, 12 reps, then we get the bicep curls. Are we ready? 3, 2, 1, let's pull. Let's go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ah, come on, heavy. 7, 8, 9, 10. Last two. 11. Slow rep to finish. Right, brilliant start to the workout. We're now gonna move on to some heavy bicep curls. Now, I'm not gonna try the 22, no chance, but I'm gonna try the 16s today. So pick your weights, which is a nice, simple, standing hamstring curl. So, it's not hamstring, are you hamstring? Bicep curl, and we're gonna try and do, I'm probably going for 8 to 10 reps. I've gone heavier today, so slightly lower reps. 8 to 10 on each side. And then we're going to go for a lighter exercise with lighter dumbbells to really burn out the biceps at the end. So, choose your weights. Remember, you want to be struggling on the last couple of reps. You might not get it right on the first set. We're going to do 3 sets of this, so you might have to do the first set, see how you go, and then adapt it. But this is probably my max effort on a bicep curl. I usually 14, so this is a bit of a step up today. Right, so one dumb on each hand. What we're gonna do from here, we're gonna rotate each dumbbell up. Ready? Let's go. So, 1, rotate down. 2, 3, 4, 5. Good tempo. 6, 7, 8. Let's go for 20, yeah? 9, 10, so 10 on each side, 20 in total, 11, 12, I've got this, 13, 14, keep lifting, come on, 15, getting heavy now, 15, 16, 17, 18, last two reps, final rep, yes, yeah, that's it, 10 on each arm, it's good for me, so I've got two more sets of them, just have a good old rest now, a good sort of minute and a half recovery, that was a good effort there. Two more sets of them, then we're going to get the light ones and do a much lighter set, but to failure, higher volume. We're going to do something called 21s, you might not have heard of this, but it's a Bunsen burner. Basically start like this, you do 7 reps just there, so 7 sort of that half lower portion of a rep, then you do 7 top to middle, and then you do 7 full reps, so it's sort of the lowest part, the upper part, and then the full extension. Oh, it burned. I'll be using those 6s for that because that really hurts. So that's going to be 2 sets of them. Right, how you feeling? Feeling good? It's a nice pace, more rest, more recovery in between, giving the muscle a real shocker, really building some strength. So obviously next time you come back, you do this workout again, try and lift a bit heavier, try and do one extra rep if you need to, but whatever it is, try and increase the intensity, progress, don't get stuck. I wouldn't get stuck on the same weight. So even if I was doing the same weights and I didn't have any more equipment, I would say, right, I did 10 this week, can I do 11 on each arm? Or can I do 12 on each arm? That's an increment, that's a progression. Right, ready? Up on our feet again. You can actually, if you want to, do them seated, but I prefer standing with these. Just don't rock them and swing up the weights too fast, control them. Right, so side on, here we go. 3, 2, 1, I want 20 reps. 1, 2, 3, elbows tucked in. 4, rotate. 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, now we're gonna get tough. Now we're gonna get tough. Come on, let's go. 11, 12, all the way. 13, 14, come on. 15, 5 more. Lift, 16. Oh, they're heavy. Come on, come on. Come on, 17, 18, one more on each side, 19, that was hard, that second set, that goes up, doesn't it? It goes up in level, even if the weight's the same. Your muscles are fatiguing, so every set gets a bit harder, so a bit more rest. One more of them. That's why I'm gonna go for the lighter stuff after this. I'm enjoying these workouts, it's giving me a nice focus, a nice different sort of challenge. And just some accountability. When I commit to something, I will get it done. So I've said 21 days. And when the baby arrives, I will find 20 minutes to come up and film one. Right. Another 45 second rest. Then we're gonna go in for that third set. Getting a good sweat on. Okay, so if you really struggle with them, if you felt that at the end, you know, you were like, leaning back, you're rocking the weights up, drop them a little bit, take the weight down, or just stop a bit sooner, maybe do 8 reps. Okay. This is definitely a progression for me, 16s. I wouldn't even want to try 18s yet because I just think I'd be all over the shop. I'd be compensating, I'd be rocking them up, so this is a good controlled weight for me. But push it, pushing me still, right. Here we go. Final set. This is gonna burn this set. Ready, let's go. One, control all the way down. Two, control it. Three, we want 20 reps. We get 20 reps, we're gonna get them. Four, five, no swinging. Six, seven, eight. Hurting now. Nine. We got this, we got the 20, have we? Yeah, we have, we have. Oh, we have. 11. 12. 13. 14. Right, this is gonna be a world of pain now. I'm going into a world of pain. 14. 15. Come on, contract that bicep. 16. 17, control it. 18, last two. Come on, lift. 19, last rep. Right, I'm well after that. Three sets of 10 with the 16 kilos. Okay, we've now got two sets. We've got two sets because they're much higher volume, they're bigger sets. It's 21 reps per set. Oh, my arms feel short, right? Shrunk. Okay, so what we're gonna do I'm gonna feel dumbs from that. So we're gonna go, and if you don't yet, you will after this. So this is what I'm gonna quickly demo for you. We're gonna be like this. We're gonna go seven reps just to the halfway point, and then we go straight in for seven, to the top, to the middle, and then it's seven, four reps. So you are gonna need a lighter weight, it's gonna burn. It's gonna burn from the out. Okay, so starting in 45 seconds. They're called 21, so seven, 14, and then bang, 21. Yes, just from the side. It's seven, so the tension is on your biceps, so seven to there. Then we come up from the top, seven to there, and then it's seven all the way up. It's a stinger. It's a stinger. These six are gonna feel like 20 when they do this workout. Right. Okay, dumbbells in the hands. Here we go. Seven reps, just to the midpoint. You ready? Three, two, one, let's go. So it's one and down. Two and down, just the halfway point. Four, elbows are tucked into the body. Five. Six. Seven, up from there, top to the middle. One. Two. Really contract. Three. Four. Seven now, seven full reps. Let's go. Control it. One. Two. Contract. Three. Four. Five. Six. Last one. Down, stretch, and curl. And rest. It's a burner. Okay, well, short little rest here. 1 minute rest. Straight back in for the second set. And we've got one more back exercise. Now, if you can, we're gonna do it with an elevated bench. You're gonna put it up here like this. If you don't have an elevated bench, you can just do another set of single arm rows, yeah? But what I'm gonna be doing is leaning forward like this. Feel the stretch and then you pull up. So if you have a nice supported back exercise, you're rowing the weight, but everything's supported. So if you don't have a incline bench, it's quite hard to do it from here, left, if the position too short. So you can do another set, if you want to, of single arm rows, and just sort of keep up with the reps. Right, last set of the bicep curls. You ready? Here we go, so 7 to the middle. 1, let's go. 2, 3, contract. 4, squeeze those biceps. 5, 6, last set on these. 7, 8, good. Now come up to the middle. 1, 2, just to the middle. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 full reps straight in. Let's go. 1, 2, slow the way down. 3, last set of the biceps. 4, control it. 5, squeeze. 6, last rep. Right, fantastic. So, last exercise now. Like I said, if you can, you're gonna elevate your bench. If not, you can do a nice single arm row. And I'm gonna go for the 16s here, so sort of middle size weight for me. Because my forearms are gone already. What I'm gonna do, I'll just demo it. Start, yeah, I'm just gonna show you what's coming. So, basically, probably a little bit harder actually. Nope. Hang on. Yeah, I've got one up. Right, so with the dumbbells, my head's just above the bench, so my chin's just resting on top of the bench. And from there, I'm gonna pull up and down. So squeezing all the muscles in my upper back. If you can't do that, just do some single arm rows. Oh. Right, so we've got 2 sets on this, and that's the end of today's back and bicep workout. Okay, so I'm ready to get on with it. First set, I'm aiming for 10 to 12 reps again. Here we go. So from here, nice strong pull up. Let's go. 1, 2, 3. 4, really pull them up, squeeze the shoulder blades together. 5, retract the shoulder blades. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 2 more. 11, and rest. Oh, decent weight there, again. Don't just pull directly up. Don't just pull up like this. Try and think about pulling like back towards your hips, so you really have to activate your lats. Oh. Been a good session this. So we're gonna go for one more set, and that winds up our workout for the day. Back and biceps complete. Right, ready for the final set? When you're ready, so either single arm rows, you can continue with those, or join me with these sort of incline bent rows where you're supported. So again, squeeze, hold the top, and lower. Last set, 12 reps to finish, workout complete. Let's go. Right, here we go. 1, 2, maximum pull. 3, 5, 6, 7, ouch,
8, 9, 10, 2 more.
Follow it.
Squeeze. And
another fantastic workout. Built some strength today, hopefully built some muscle. The important thing is to have a lot of water today. You know, refuel with some protein, some carbohydrates. Get a good night's sleep, because all the repairing, the muscle really builds overnight when you're sleeping, so get some good sleep. Fuel your body. Have a fantastic day, and thanks for joining me again. And I'll see you tomorrow for day number 8 of the 21 Days of Strength Challenge. See you there.